Welcome back, everyone. Today I'm still working on the QS72 motor. I have the phase leads and they are way too long to go into the controller, so I'm going to shorten them. I have a wire cutter, a terminal crimper, and some shrink wrap tubing. I'll put the link in the description where you can get these. And as you can see, that's way too long, so I'm going to shorten it right about there. This cutter is really nice. I got it from Amazon. I'm just going to do a test cut. That was fantastic. These phase wires have color coding on the ends, and I'm cutting the ends off. So I'm gonna put new color coding on the beginning, so that way I do not forget what color is what. You can't cut this and make it longer, so you have to cut it once and do it right, or cut it long and then make it shorter. So I'm gonna cut it right about here. Okay, there we go. My wire strippers is not big enough for this, so I'm just gonna use an X-Acto. They do make a wire cutter for this. I just didn't wanna buy one. Make sure this fits all the way in. Perfect. You can put this terminal on and make sure you align it so it's gonna bolt on nice right about there. I'm gonna go one size down smaller since this thing is still a little loose. All right. Woo. There we go, that one's crimped. Put your shrink tubing over. Now we can attach these. There's one. Now we just have to do green, and then we have to do blue. Little there. All right, we've got our phase wires. All right, I got all the phase wires shortened. They're connected correctly. The crimper was a little funny. I feel like the size isn't quite accurate for the terminals. It did work fine, but I had to play with it. I did a larger size and then I did a smaller size instead of just going to the right size. I'm going to use these again for the battery terminals. I'll put a link in the description where you can get the terminals, the crimper, the cutter, and the shrink wrap. Let me know if you have any questions. Please like and subscribe, and buy me a coffee if you can. Thanks.